Chris Hardwick and Mike Furman. Hard and Firm. And they're both really, like, Chris is posing. Really, it's impressive how, I feel like he works out. You would have to have a really strong core to do that, unless he's really propped up in some way, you know, or like, I don't know, there's a harness or something. He strikes me as a guy, he does, you know, he might even be a martial artist. I don't even know. Gotta be honest. Now, Mike's posing, it's like, I see that and I'm like, I could do that. But Chris says, I honestly don't know. Or if I could, I would bitch about it. I bet I would. Paul F. Tompkins. He's another sharp-dressed guy. Man after my own heart. Got some sweet boxing gloves on here. When I was a kid, I went to the department store. I can't remember which one. One of them in Cleveland. And there were these Everlast boxing gloves. And I wanted them so badly because I would watch, you know, all the boxing greats on TV on the weekends just beating the shit out of each other. So being, you know, about 8 years old and all, I thought, you know, I should probably get some boxing gloves so I can beat the crap out of, you know, my friends. So I begged my dad to get me boxing gloves. And he was like, no, son, no. And then finally, like, I just annoyed the shit out of him. So he finally is like, fine, I'll get you boxing gloves. And he usually didn't give in to me like that. But I think I really just really put on a show. And he got me the gloves. And I thought, cool, now I'll go beat the crap out of all my friends in the neighborhood. And so we started having boxing matches. And you'd pair off with the other kids in the neighborhood. And the joke was on me. Because I got my ass kicked. Just over and over and over again. I thought the gloves looked so great sitting on the department store shelf, but when they were coming at my face, not so much. Jessica St. Clair, it looks like she's in like a hull of a ship or something. I'm worried about her. I don't know. It looks like, well, she's fine. I mean, I know she's doing fine now. I guess I don't need to worry. She's doing fine. I don't need to get emotionally invested in this photograph. I do like it, though. The first television program I ever was on, I say that like I've been on a shitload of television programs, like I'm, you know, Michael J. Fox or something. But the first show I was ever on was Smoking Gun TV, and Jessica was on that show, too. That's all I got for that one. That's my showbiz story. I like to give, you know, showbiz insights. What with being a showbiz professional and all. I don't have any stories beyond that from, you know, hilarious anecdotes from the craft service table from that show or anything. But I do remember one day I was shooting something and Jessica was showing up later. And I finished and Jessica showed up and I said, hey, Jessica, how's it going? She was like, hey, Dave. Good, how are you? I'm like, I'm good. And then I was like, oh, I'll see you later. And she's like, okay, cool, good seeing you. So that was a quality hang. Frangela. This is Frangela, which is two women fused into one. I wonder how that works. Like, do they get just one person's money and then they have to split that? And then they're like, I don't know if this was a good idea. Or maybe I'm sure everything's great. I don't know if these are bananas or plantains that they're holding here. I want to say they're plantains. The reason I bring it up, why the differentiation, is I heard this from somewhere. It wasn't because it was on the internet and, you know, you click on one thing and click on another and another and another. Eventually you find yourself on a web page that explains to you how you can fuck up plantain skin. I'm just saying I heard that there's a website that explains that, not that I've seeing it. What's wrong with me? Okay, I'm fine. 80 miles. He's a handsome man, isn't he? I've always thought that. I don't think I've ever said it out loud. But I'm confident and comfortable saying it. So if he hears this, deal with it. I think you're handsome, AD. He's cooking a cat, a kitty cat. Is that a real cat? Cats are maybe the only animal that sometimes end up so adorable in real life that you don't, they seem fake. I think this, I'm looking at it. It's weird. Like, I was getting closer and closer, and I was like, that's a fake kitty cat. And then I got even closer, and I was kind of like, well, I think it might be a real kitty cat. Not important. But I love the shot. I had a dog growing up. I'm allergic to cats. A lot of people don't know that, but that's another fun bit of trivia. But growing up, I had a pet golden retriever. He ended up biting me. He maimed me, basically. That's a story for another time. But I was throwing a tennis ball around the house. And we, you know, it was after school, and I was making some Kraft macaroni and cheese or some bullshit. And I left the burner on. And it wasn't a gas burner. It was just like electrical stove. And the ball went on. This is horrible. I feel so bad about it. It went, bounced on the stove, and the dog went up to get it. And he put his poor little guy. Well, he's a huge dog. He was like a 90 pounds violent animal. He put his paw on the burner and was like, oh, fuck. I mean, he didn't say, couldn't talk. He's a dog. But the sound he made, oh, I feel so bad about it. But he basically said the dog equivalent of, oh, fuck. Poor guy. We had to put him to sleep. Not my idea. It's my dad's. Bobby Tisdale. He looks determined here. Oh, this, I know where this is shot. This is shot at the Black Rabbit. Bobby Bingo at the Black Rabbit in Greenpoint. My favorite bar in the world, maybe. It's one of those bars that, like, I want to tell people to go there because it's a great bar and my friends own it, which is, if you're going to go to a bar, it's good to go to a bar that your friends own because it tends to be cheaper. You know, it's one of those things. I've been there many times, but I don't remember leaving. Huh. The joke there is I pretty much drink myself into a blackout every time I go there. In fact, it's not far from where I am right now recording this. And part of me is like, I should probably go there and drink myself into a blackout after this. Anyway, the reason I bring it up, Bobby Bingo, every Sunday night. I don't think he's doing it anymore. I wish he did. He's a handsome man, too. Something in the water. They're from North Carolina, right? North Carolina. Handsome fellas. Nice red hair. Jon Glaser. This is a... I've seen this. The little baby man hands. It's creepy. And the thing is, the cat probably is not even fazed by it, because cats don't give a fuck about anything. Now it almost looks, I don't know. See, this is my hip. I keep thinking, well, you couldn't masturbate with those hands. But that's my own problem. That's not a judgment on John or anything. But yeah, now it's all I can think about. Let's keep moving. Okay.